This is Aaron. He has been complaining of an itchy scalp and describes his scalp as powdery. He does a Google search on what his condition may be and stumbles upon seborrheic dermatitis, or SD for short, and scalp psoriasis. Aaron is confused on the difference between the two conditions and asks the demystifying team to explain the differences. SD is a common skin condition that mainly affects the scalp, causing itchy red patches and greasy scales. Psoriasis, on the other hand, is a chronic autoimmune disease that causes bumpy red patches covered with white scales. In this video, we will discuss the differences between SD and psoriasis through understanding its symptoms, etiology, and treatments, focusing mainly on its localization on the scalp. While SD and psoriasis have similar physical characteristics, there are some characteristics that can help differentiate the two. So let's start with the symptoms. SD is generally characterized by red patches with yellow scales on the skin. However, it may present differently on different skin tones. For example, patients with darker skin may experience hypopigmentation or hyperpigmentation. Some people may also lack redness while others have minimal scaling. So SD does have a lot of physical presentations. Although psoriasis is also characterized by red scaling lesions, it tends to have a grayish-whitish overcast instead of yellow. And it generally appears red or pinkish in lighter skin tones and darker or purplish in darker skin tones. In terms of location, SD is usually found in areas where there are loads of sebaceous glands, like the face, scalp, upper chest, and upper back. When present on the face, it is commonly found on lips, ears, eyelids, the sides of the nose, and between the eyebrows. Similar to SD, psoriasis often affects the scalp. However, it rarely appears solely on the scalp, so you'll probably find it on other body parts, like the knees, elbows, body folds, and even nails. However, this is rare. It also typically appears with a symmetrical distribution across the body and has well-defined borders. Texture-wise, SD tends to result in flaky, greasy-looking patches, whereas psoriasis is said to have a drier, powdery appearance. Now, based on all of this, a doctor should be able to determine if Aaron has SD or psoriasis. The exact cause of SD is still unknown. However, dermatologists believe that Malassezia, a fungal yeast naturally present on our skin, and sebum, the oils naturally produced by our skin, play important roles in the development of SD. Perhaps SD symptoms are a reaction to an overgrowth of Malassezia yeast on our skin. Dermatologists have found that patients who are treated with an antifungal medication, the one that removes some of the yeast from the skin, get relief from their SD symptoms and some even get clear skin. However, when antifungal treatment is stopped and the yeast is allowed to grow again, SD returns. Skin specialists have noticed that SD is actually more common during times of higher sebum production in the body. SD also develops on areas of the body with higher sebum, like the scalp, face, and chest. Due to these observations, dermatologists believe that Malassezia feeds on sebum and grows, causing the body to react, resulting in SD symptoms. Although the exact cause of SD may still be unknown, we do know that SD is not an allergy, and it is not caused by unclean skin. Fortunately, we have more information about the cause of psoriasis. According to scientists, psoriasis may be linked to one's immune system and genes. Psoriasis develops due to an immune system dysfunction. When we get infected, T cells of the immune system kills infected cells, shown in red here. That makes us sick. However, in psoriasis patients, the immune system falsely perceives a threat and the T cells attack healthy skin cells, shown here in blue, which causes the body to produce new skin cells more often. This results in a buildup of extra skin cells on the surface of the skin, causing psoriasis. Researchers have also found that individuals with certain genes are more likely to develop psoriasis. Since genes are shared across family members, if you have a family history of psoriasis, you have a higher risk of developing the condition. It is important to clarify that neither SD nor psoriasis are contagious, meaning you will not contract these conditions if you are in contact with someone who has either SD or psoriasis. Now let's talk about factors that may exacerbate these conditions. Both SD and psoriasis may be triggered due to stress, hormonal changes, smoking, heavy alcohol consumption, and cold, dry weather conditions. Triggers begin to differ in that SD can also be aggravated by the use of harsh soaps and chemicals, and medications such as psoralin, a psoriasis treatment we discussed earlier, and interferon, an antiviral. Psoriasis triggers, on the other hand, include skin injuries like cuts, insect bites, sunburns, strep throat, and medications such as ibuprofen, which is an anti-inflammatory drug, and ACE inhibitors, which is a blood pressure medication. Since SD can often be confused with psoriasis, treatments can sometimes be ineffective. It is important to consider who the treatment is intended for. For example, in infants, SD is known as cradle cap. Typically, no treatment is required as it will resolve itself within the first 12 months after birth. In the meantime, using a mild baby shampoo or massaging the scalp gently using a very soft brush can help. Generally though, over-the-counter shampoos and medications such as topical treatments are usually enough to improve flaking and soothe itching. Topical treatments are the first treatments used for mild to moderate psoriasis. Topical corticosteroids are directly administered to your skin or scalp. It is a type of steroid medicine that may help reduce inflammation and slow the growth of skin cells and can come in a variety of formulations, including creams, lotions, gels, and ointments. Phototherapy uses natural and artificial light to treat psoriasis. There are two main treatment options that uses phototherapy. Ultraviolet B, or UVB for short, a wavelength of light invisible to human eyes that slows down the production of skin cells and is an effective treatment for some types of psoriasis that may have not responded to topical treatments. The second option is psoralin plus ultraviolet A, or PUVA for short, where the patient receives psoralin, a drug that becomes active when it is exposed to light. The drug can be taken orally or applied to the skin, followed by the ultraviolet A radiation. This light penetrates your skin more deeply than UVB light. So, going back to our case study, Aaron visited his doctor and was diagnosed with scalp psoriasis. The doctor could put Aaron on various treatment options, such as topical corticosteroids or phototherapy. So overall, while SD and psoriasis are similar skin conditions, both conditions differ in symptoms, etiology, and treatment options. The physical presentation of SD is flaky and greasy and is believed to be caused by malassezia, while psoriasis appears more dry and powdery and is an autoimmune condition.